let's talk about one man that we haven't seen.
In fact, I hear Linus talk about Madaraka Day, and I hope that President Uhuru Kenyatta will attend the Madaraka Day celebrations in Narok County, because he's missing in action. Actually, has been since the China trip. I've had people ask, did he come back? Yes, he did. He's around. Probably the...
How do you know?
Because at least we have seen Gazette notices coming around, appointing various people.
But those can
but
be done
even
can,
anyway. But there's also a confirmation. But there's also a confirmation that he's around. Lakini
well, he is working, Maji. Do you need to see him? It reminds me of when former President Moi was, you know, he was in the news all the time, and when he wasn't, you know, there was concern, even when it turned out he had a home.
It is interesting, actually. How often should we see the president? I think that's the question.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And Kenyans have a legitimate expectation to see him once or twice in a week, whatever. Why? Because it's always been like that. So if you have accustomed us to this thing of seeing you all the time, then when you go missing, then something is
but
wrong.
But do you remember actually when the president went on leave last year?
Yep.
Was it for three weeks?
But it was said by Sitaus that he has actually retreated to Mombasa to take a break.
But you have to see him to know he's working, he's signing Gazette notices.
Look, historically, visibility is part of the execution of the office of the president. People want to see what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And this is actually global. It's not even just a Kenyan phenomenon. When Trump plays golf in Mar-a-Lago or one of his other properties, it becomes an issue, especially if there are other pressing national matters that were going on there. Now, in Kenya as well, our culture has been, where is the president? I remember later in the, I think, 97, 98, when President Moi disappeared for a few days. Mm. And we went to Arambe Avenue. He disappeared actually for about 3 or 4 days. Mm-hmm. Nobody knew where he was. And remember, this was item number one. Every time in the news, you know.
You know
where he is. Leo alikuwa. Leo ali. Udhuria, all
na
those.
Jana alikuwa na shughuli nyingi. I read those things on radio, so
did.
I know them very well.
And you knew the cost
I can redo
right.
A script.
So it was very unusual that he disappeared. He wasn't anywhere in the public. And I remember people were crying. Women were crying on Arambe Avenue when he turned up and walked.
Yeah.
He walked out there and he was pocketing. He didn't have his rungu.
Yes.
And he said, sasa kipata kamasi kidogo. Because, you know, presidential appearances and disappearances are news items. They are issues of public concern. And again, what is the role of the president? Inspire the country. Every time you wake up, because your office is that big, it's the national boundaries of the country, you can't associate them with offices the same way you do accountants.
But have
you know?
We not been inspired because we haven't seen President Uhuru Kenyatta since we last saw him in China? And maybe we can just remind our viewers.
First of all, we don't know
the last
what
time we saw
happened
him.
In China. I think that's one of the, well, these are the images.
Yeah.
And,
but do you feel that the country has
and those
not
those
been
deals were very big, you know, avocados and all that. Probably it would have been great for him to actually give like a news briefing at
of Makodofias.
Maybe at the airport or something.
Okay. Yeah.
And Kenyans do adjust. And Joe, you remember very well, Mwai Kibaki, former president, was also not for many public appearances.
No, he wasn't.
More of an office,
yes, right.
Office person. He could work from State House for the week.
Mm-hmm.
He rarely went to Harambe House. But at least information came out on what he's doing. There's been some silence from the time the president went to China.
Unless he's trying to fire some people, you know, because there's also a tradition.
They don't have to do it in hiding.
It is a tradition in this country that also that when they want to fire people or reshuffle or something, they disappear, then they emerge with something that then the country can talk about.
I can hear Jamila from home, but I wish she was here. There's some Swahili saying that ukiona sijui kobe ameinamisha kichwa anatunga sheria or something like that.
Mm.
So there's something about silence. And probably as you allude, maybe something is happening behind the scenes and maybe his reappearance will be with a thunder.
Yeah.
And I hope so. And
well,
in
we've
the meantime,
heard of this thunder, though. Yeah, yeah, I mean, from the beginning of this year, either arrest or
the anticipation
being sacked,
has been a bit too much. Yeah.
Have faith,
but, more.
But remember, thunder only comes when there are rains, and
absolutely.
You know, we've had delayed rains for a long
time.
It's
been drizzling for a while, so maybe there's prospect.
But even then, there are serious national issues to be addressed, and there are some issues that require responses and answers. But maybe there's also a question about how government communicates some of these things. And we saw the appointment of Cyrus Oguna recently. Mm-hmm. Maybe it speaks about some subtle shift in terms of how the government is communicating or wants to communicate issues to the public. And I wouldn't be surprised if there could be a few more changes in that line in terms of how government communicates. Maybe we'll see a few changes here and there.
To be fair, there's been quite a bit of communication since China. I mean, CS Monica Juma, told us in
on Twitter,
very categorical on Twitter. Now that the president is not on Twitter either, by the way, talked about what happened or didn't happen. We've heard from James Macharia about meter gauge railway or not, as we're seeing in the papers. I mean, there's been quite a bit of communication. Even Zioka Waita has been speaking.
But
about,
he's not. But
you know,
he's not
what's
the
happening.
But he's not the State House spokesperson, is he?
Okay, guys. Before we go, I have an update.
I hope I've not said many things
I have,
by saying that.
I have an.
He's got an important update.
You have an important update.
I have an important update.
South African elections.
No. From Uganda. Last week, we actually were speaking about these three people that NBS was required to suspend by the Uganda Communications Commission because they had done certain things which were not specified. Turned out it was related to their coverage of Bobby Wine mm-hmm. and this whole house arrest thing and that sort of thing. But anyways, so there was a meeting between the National Association of Broadcasters there and the UCC, the regulator.
Right.
And then an interesting statement came out of that from the UCC, which said that actually they had not, when the commission clarified that suspension of certain individuals by broadcasters meant that the commission has directed that the affected broadcasters should not be suspended from their employment at the media house, but rather be requested to step aside to pave way for investigations. It went on to say that they did not mean they should leave their jobs, that actually they are suspended, but they are within the organization, only that they are not playing the roles that they were playing on that particular day. So very interesting.
I'm confused. So are they suspended or not? What are they asking for?
The one thing, and this is totally weird, the one thing I admire about the UCC is its honesty. Mm-hmm. It has actually come out in the open and said, we want these journalists out.
Mm-hmm.
It's in writing. It's in writing. Does it happen elsewhere?
They don't want them out of the organization.
They don't want them out.
Let them hang around there, just not do the jobs they were doing on that day. Very interesting.
But they put it in fine print.
Yes.
You remember a similar case here, this misspeak. Ruben Dolo? Weka tire.
Ukiona wao.
Then niliposema weka tire.
Sikusema
weka tire. Nilimaanisha weka tire, gari isonge mbele.
Gari ipite, yes.
And that was not in writing.
What does that mean?
Yeah.
But at least the fact that they are engaging with the broadcasters and having meetings,
yes,
it's moving the needle in the right direction, I think.
Absolutely.